Oh, this was funny. Well, it wasn't funny actually. I had a memory card in slot 2, right? And I went to like load data off it, and it said this is on the Wii, and it said the memory card is corrupted and must be formatted. And oh, okay, TG. Yes, yeah, sorry, TGD. Unfortunately, the answer's no. Me and Al both are taking a pretty serious break, it's awesome that you're doing the run again, but I really don't have it in me to do another full commentary run right now. So, sorry, but I look forward to seeing the run. Speaking of awesome runs, everybody right now, go to YouTube, go to Kel's channel, and subscribe to him. Or her, I don't actually know if it's a guy or a girl. But whether or not, he's making videos again of NG. He's got chapter 1 up of his Ninja Dog Karma run. And he's got some great mission mode videos. He's without a doubt one of the best players. Me and Al have mentioned him God knows how many times in videos. Check out his channel. His videos are amazing. Hey Suso, what's up? Yeah, this is the Wii wary. This is the Wii via component. Which looks a little better, I suppose. Come on you guys. You're on Twitch. This means you're probably on a PC. You can go to YouTube, but I will do that for you because I'm so nice. He's in my subscription box. Damn straight. Really looking forward to the Ninja Dog run too, because that's another thing about that difficulty. A lot of people don't understand. Like, it's very very hard to karma run Ninja Dog. It's a nightmare to karma run that difficulty. You know what else is great about this game? Is unlike NG, you can leave it on the pause menu and it doesn't add to your time. Here he is. Here we go, people. Oh, you beat me to it. Okay. There we go. I love that dodge. It just looks so trolly when you do the side jump. There we go. I mean, any difficulty is hard on a karma run. Yeah, Ninja Dog's hard, man. It's hard as difficulty. That might cost me the time bonus. Nah, we're fine. Just do it. But yeah, Ninja Dog is really tough to karma run. I'd say karma running difficulty probably goes hard. Normal and Ninja Dog are kind of the same. Then probably very hard Master Ninja. They're all hard for different reasons, but like, you don't have to be that good at the actual game on Master Ninja and very hard. Like, if you can get through those difficulties, you're fine, and you can still get a pretty decent score. Whereas on the lower difficulties, funnily enough, like, you really have to be very very precise. That might not do it, but okay. Yeah, I disagree on that, Godfather. It's not the hardest. It's the most time-consuming, but it's not the hardest. Like, nothing is really hard to do, you know what I mean? Like, in terms of execution. Like, you have 5 years to kill every boss. I'd say very hard has probably got the hardest boss fights on a karma run. Because of the you don't have a whole lot of time, but then again, you don't have the means to get UTs either. Like, hard, you have the worst of everything. You have the harshest fight time limits, you have the harshest chapter time limits, you have the harshest essence requirements because of the time limits. That's the main thing that... The main thing that goes against the higher difficulties is the amount of time you have. The amount of time just makes stuff like essence management and that just a joke. It's so easy. That's gonna be close. Oh, that was close. I'll briefly... Oh, yeah, those little things that come up... Ooh, that's lucky. Those little things that scan you, not really sure what they do. I haven't figured that out yet. But when they finish scanning you, they actually disappear, and then you can't kill them. So you, once they start doing that, like, you have to take them out, otherwise you won't get full combo. And you can kill every enemy in a room without full comboing it, and you'll still get the no damage bonus. That's what you have to do to get it. But if an enemy disappears or an enemy self-destructs, even if you do the room full combo, no damage, barring that enemy, you won't get the no damage bonus because you didn't actually kill every enemy in the room. Yeah, exactly, DG, yeah. Like, chapter 1 is such a... Oh, that's evil, though. That first gauntlet in chapter 1, it's so hard to get a run you're happy with, because you can get 7 out of the 8 fights perfect, and then that last fight, or like the fight before it or whatever, like, can just go to complete shit. You can lose literally like 25k in the blink of an eye, and then your run's dead. Right, this room. This room is a pain. I do have extra energy, though. I could actually use 2 Tengu Pros here if I wanted to, because I got lucky and got an energy pickup. Let's see. Everybody, remind me not to jump back twice on the boss. Now we go this way. Let's see, dimming. Please give me energy. Oh my god! Shit! That's a really annoying thing. Like, sometime... Did he... Oh, please tell me he didn't blow up. Ooh, that was close. Sometimes I can't quite see the health bar, like, as I'm moving. So I think they're one shot, but they're not. And that happens. I assume they're one shot, and then I shoot them once, and they don't die, and then I'm fucked. Right, that takes care of him. So yeah, in hindsight, I could have actually used 2 Tengus, but I got hit, so it doesn't really make a difference. Although, I do have full energy now, I can go back and pick that up. Yeah, that's exactly what we'd mean, Godfather, really. It's the closest run I've seen to that, maximum, is Ice Lord's hard run. And even that, he misses points. Like, there is points for the next guy on that run. You know, if they really want to do it, he can be beat. That score can be beat. And I think that's ultimately what keeps the Karma run... like, kind of the quote-unquote perfect Karma run from ever happening. The amount of dedication and time it would take to literally get every single fight in the game perfect. And by perfect, let me finish this, actually. So, because perfect is misleading in NG. You can get a fight perfect, but then you can do it a different way, and you might stumble upon something that you just never thought of. Like, for example, in my very hard run, I show how you can get an extra ET by burning a talisman in Chapter 4. That was a complete accident. Like, I didn't intend to do that. That's just something that happened while I was playing. And I just realized it and thought, oh shit, like, you know, that's totally possible. You would never sort of go into a fight like that with the kind of game plan of burning a talisman on man-sized enemies. Like, you just wouldn't do that, you know? But that is how you get the best score. This is tricky. The hitbox on that move is absolutely bananas, by the way. It might look like I'm kind of over-dodging that, but... like, the splash damage on it is way, way more than you would think. Screw you. Okay, now you seem to be in a strafing mood. So hold this Pegasus. Man, and I still got shafted. Ah, that was kind of annoying, actually, because, like, there really wasn't anything I could have done there. Oh, well. I've still got that last room to freaking full combo. I need to make sure I'm out of that cannon's trajectory. There is a little sweet spot that you can get, like where you'll block the cannon's laser on the wall, but you can still shoot it. But that's one downside of the game's camera. It is kind of hard to really get like accurate positions like on the fly. Yeah, it's true. Yeah, that's exactly it, Godfather. But it's weird because playing against those things is the most infuriating thing in the game. But when you see it on video, it's just it's like, you know, it's like watching just everything fall into, you know, it's like watching a speed video of a puzzle, of a jigsaw puzzle, you know? When you see everything come together perfectly, it just... nothing beats that. That was very close. My HUD's kind of in my way. Right. Gotta wait this out now. The rocket guys haven't spawned, which is going to make this really tricky. I have to jump a bit further to get them to spawn. I was hoping I'd get, like... I was hoping I'd get that before they lasered, but... No, don't do that. That was so close to killing that laser. Damn it. Well, the combo is more important. Shit! God damn it. Right, let's go. Energy drive, please. Don't do that to me. That looked so cool. That looked totally like I meant to dodge those rockets, but I didn't. Fuck you. Yes! Whew. I kinda got pummeled there, but doesn't matter. Oh man. Recently actually spent 7 hours in the blue red room gauntlet for no damage. That gauntlet's a fucking nightmare, man. Yeah. It's so annoying. The blue red room, it's the Hydra Cubus gauntlet, Sousa, in chapter 7. The blue room, the rooms in between, and then you've got cat fiends with Hydra Cubus. Yep. It's so difficult. Because, like, sometimes the cat fiends don't do this. Like, if the cat fiends don't swipe at you, like, you're okay, but that's their main attack, you know? Sometimes the zombie archers are just snipers, and it's just boom. They're just so accurate sometimes. So I could actually use another Tengu here if I want it, or really want it. I think that's less points than I was here with last time. Another thing, it might not be seeable on the stream because the quality is not that good, but when you're when you're constantly palm shotting a laser turret, it can be quite difficult to actually see when they're winding up to shoot at you, because the effect like kind of obscures that a little bit, like your palm shot hitting it, which is not the best. See there? I was getting like just a little bit greedy. Don't do that. That attack kills you if it hits you, so. I wish the GameCube had a left like shoulder top button. Cause X to swap targets is goddamn terrible. It's such a bad button to swap targets with. If it had like an L1 equivalent, it'd be so much better. Sorry guys, oh hey Bio, thanks for stopping by, man. I'll catch up with the chat in a second. I don't want to get hit here, fucking avoid it. That really reminds me of a Stormbird from Horizon Zero Dawn. Energy drive, you piece of shit! That was close. That's the equivalent of Ryu, like, attacking a door versus the enemy, is when you miss an energy drive. Because god, it kills you. Yeah, my internet was died last week, so I couldn't stream last weekend, which was a shame. Oops. Right, remember, do not jump backwards twice. That would be bad. I need to make a note of how many points you get for this. 19-4-1. Because I have a feeling it's like sod all. Oh, also on hard mode, you don't get that massive flurry of free damage. Ooh, I dodged way too early there. And there. Oh well. I'm not sure if you get no damage bonuses on the bosses either. From what I know, I don't actually think it makes a difference. Tengu here. Thanks, hon. Yeah, I remember. Don't jump back twice. I got hit by the bloody lasers, though. That's a blow up. Oh, this frame rate. Alright, it's about to run out any second. Ah, come on. Energy drive. Energy. Fuck's sake. That's happening less and less. Because I guess I'm just getting used to the controller again, but. It really is infuriating when that happens. Like, if it happened there, for example, I was dead. This should kill him, though. And in a weird way, like, I'm kind of sad this run's over. It's been really fun to, like, dissect the game. But, annoyingly enough, like, just... I want like the highest score I can possibly get. Wow, so you get 15,000 for the boss. That's nothing. I want to see what the highest amount of points is, and just easy mode is what's going to give me that, which is a real shame. But I do have something in plan for hard mode, which will be pretty cool and pretty tough. So I got something in the works for that. Cool. Man, this game is so good. This game is so good. And this music. Can we talk about this music? Ooh, I have matchmakers. I'm gonna rip into these bad boys. I haven't played Blackout in a while, come to think of it. They removed 9 bangs from Blackout. Kind of surprised at that. People were crying. Like, they removed 9 bangs, but... like, they kept everything else. He's really good too. These salted caramel matchmakers, man. Top tier. It's funny as well. Playing this, really makes me want to play Vanquish. I don't think so, Bio. No, that's the main thing that's kept me off it. I did play it Monday. Not Monday, sorry, Tuesday when I got my net back. Literally two games in a row. Right at the start of the match, someone literally sprinted right up behind me. One of them even jumped through a glass window. I heard nothing. I heard absolutely nothing. It's the audio stuff is infuriating in that game. Like, people crying about nine bangs, and yet, like, all, like, literally everybody is saying how broken the audio is. Everybody. And yet, they don't, I don't know, I've heard nothing about them fixing the audio. I do like that suit, the black and red one. That looks cool. Even though that is a really good suit, the Ultra Guardian, I hate the way it looks. I really don't like that colour scheme. Imagine if Team Ninja made this, like, how many different suits they'd be. They'd be like DLC with, like, 20 different suits. That's her getting up off the floor animation. See, I play this game way too much. These are very Moorish. So, was that all rooms full combo? I think it was, wasn't it? It's Jill Valentine. Hey, 2 million. Alright, cool. It's slightly faster.